Yashi Goyal, I am legal intern at Lexis & Company. In this video, I'll be talking about the essential of valid marriage. So before that, let's talk about what is marriage. Marriage under old Hindu legal system is considered to be a sacred ritual and an eternal union or a sacred tie that can't be broken. Before the codification of Hindu law, marriage was a samskara. In old Hindu culture, the successful attainment of 16 samskara is considered of a paramount importance in the course of one's natural life. And according to renowned Hindu thinker Manu, the Vivaha samskara is one of the most important ones.
The relation of husband and wife is considered to make for several lifetimes. And once a person enters into a marriage, it cannot be dissolved. Therefore, both have to spend their entire lives with each other. It is a reasoning that wife is called Dharmapatni or second half. For this reason, a Hindu woman can't remarry after the death of her husband. But this rule was changed after the commencement of Hindu Widow Remarry Act 1856.
In law, marriages may mean either the acts, agreements or the ceremony by which two people enter into wedlock or their subsequent relations created thereby. In India, marriages are governed by personal laws or family laws. There exist different laws for each religion. Hindu marriages are governed according to the Hindu Marriage Act 1955 and other Hindu laws. Hindu marriages is not only a sacrament but also a contract. According to Vedas, a marriage is a union of flesh with flesh and bones with bones. So, before the enactment of Hindu Marriage Act 1955, Hindu marriages were governed by dharmashastras and customs. When we talk about Hindu Marriage Act, Section 2 of the Hindu Marriage Act says that both the parties of marriage should be Hindu, otherwise the marriage will not be considered as valid under this act. If one of the parties to the marriage is not Hindu and the other is Hindu, or both the parties are not Hindu, then the marriage will not be subject to a matter of this act and not considered as valid under this act. But this will relate to some other laws, for example, Special Marriage Act 1957 or any other laws.
So now let's talk about the essentials of a valid marriage. Section 5 of Hindu Marriage Act 1955 talks about the essential conditions for the valid marriage. First essential of the valid marriage is monogamous relationship. According to Section 5, Clause 1 of Hindu Marriage Act says that neither the party should have a spouse living at the time of marriage. It implies a monogamous act and makes a barrier on a bigamous and polygamous act. It should be read with Section 11 and Section 17 of Hindu Marriage Act. According to Section 11, bigamous and polygamous is null and void act. And apart from this, Section 17 makes this a punishable offence under Section 494 and 495 of Indian Penal Code 1860. And it ultra-vires the Constitution on the ground that it violates Article 14, 15 and 25 Clause 1 of the Indian Constitution. Therefore, the parties to the marriage can be unmarried, widowed or divorced. The second essential of a valid marriage is free consent. According to Section 5, Clause 2 of the Hindu Marriage Act says that at the time of marriage, neither party shall be incapable of giving free consent on the basis of insanity, mental disorder or unsoundness of mind, as they are unfit for marriage and procreation of children. Free consent is a necessary element of a Hindu marriage. A Hindu marriage takes contravention of this condition, which is not in per se void but voidable under Section 12, Clause 1, Subclause B of the Act. The third essential of a valid marriage is age. According to Section 5, Clause 3 of Hindu Marriage Act says that at the time of marriage, the male shall be minimum of 21 years of age and female 18 years of age. Any violation of the required age of this clause is not void or even voidable, but it is a breach of a condition which is punishable with a simple imprisonment of 15 days or with a fine or with both given under Section 18, Clause A of this Act.
Also, Section 10 of Prohibition of Child Marriage Act 2006 provides that any person who is performing, conducting or directing a child marriage shall be punished with rigorous imprisonment of up to 2 years and fine of 1 lakh rupees. So, the fourth essential of the valid marriage is prohibited relationship. According to Section 5, Clause 4 of the Hindu Marriage Act says that neither party shall fall under the degree of prohibited relationship except when such union is allowed by customs or usage. A marriage is solemnized within the prohibited degree of a relationship would be void and which is given under Section 11 of the Act and is punishable for simple imprisonment which may extend to 1 month or fine or with both which is given under Section 18 Clause B of this Act. If a custom is prevailing, it must be valid custom under Section 3 Clause A of the Hindu Marriage Act. The marriage constituted within the degree of prohibited relationship will only become valid or legal if there exists a valid custom.
So, the fifth essential of a valid marriage is spinda relationship. According to Section 3, Clause F, Subclause 2 of Hindu Marriage Act says that two persons are said to be spindas of each other under two conditions. First, if one is the lenient ascendant of the other within the limit of spinda relationship, or second, if they have a common lenient ascendant who are within the limits of spinda relationship with reference to each other. So, spinda marriages are liable for the punishment under Section 18, Subclause B of the Act. Thus, according to this section, marriages between persons of blood relationship are void. The next essential, that is sixth essential of a valid marriage is marriage ceremonies. According to Section 7 of Hindu Marriage Act, which talks about the necessary ceremonial rites, according to this, solemnization of Hindu marriage may be performed by all the ceremonies and rituals of both the parties for either of them, and these rituals are mainly concerned with invocation before the sacred fire and satpati, which means taking 7 rounds of the fire with the partner in the northeast direction. After the completion of these rituals, the marriage becomes binding and complete for both the parties.
So the seventh and the last essential of a valid marriage is registration of marriage. According to Section 8 of Hindu Marriage Act, the Hindu marriage may be registered within the 15 days of solemnization of marriage as prescribed by the state government. Registration provides a written proof of the marriage. However, if such rules got violated, the marriage will not be held void, but the parties can be made liable to pay fine. So, these are the essential conditions of a valid marriage given under Hindu law. Hindu marriage is not only a sacrament but a contract too. As soon as the marriage is completed, it gives certain marital rights and duties to both husband and wife. Thank you.